Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 public beta is now available to install for those that want to test it out. And this is available to all iOS 14 supported devices. So if you had an iPhone 6S or you have an iPhone SE, for example, or 6S Plus, you'll be able to try out the beta if you want to. Now keep in mind, it is a beta and it can have some bugs, but in order to install this, I want to walk you through step by step what you should do. And the first thing you should do is make sure you have a backup. And you can do that one of two ways. You can do that either in iTunes on a Windows computer or on Finder on a Mac, or the easiest way is to use iCloud. So if you have enough iCloud storage, just go to Settings, tap on your name at the top, tap on iCloud, and under iCloud, if you have all of these different things, apps using iCloud, for example, your mail, messages in the cloud, those things will just be there either way. However, you want to make sure you have a backup. So if you scroll down, go to iCloud backup, you can see when the last backup was if you have this turned on. You'll see it was yesterday for me at 5:51 PM. If that's good enough, we're good to go. If not, tap on backup now. And as long as you're on Wi-Fi, or maybe not on Wi-Fi, if you have a good signal, or your home and plugged in, you can back up now. So it will let you know if you need any of those things. Once you're backed up, you're good to go. The other way to do that, like I said, is using a computer, plug it in through the lightning cable and back it up directly on the computer. Now, once you're satisfied that you have a backup that's recent, go ahead and either unplug it or let's go back and install the beta. Now, what we need to do is go to Apple's website in order to install this. So we'll go to Safari, and then we need to go to beta.apple.com or apple.com/beta. So if we just go to apple.com, put in /beta, hit go, it will bring us to the beta website. Now, this will show you all the betas available. And if you're not signed up already with your Apple ID, go ahead and sign up. If you are signed up, maybe from a previous beta, for example, go ahead and go into sign in. Now, once you're signed in, on the next page, you can just select the beta you want. We're already on iOS, for example, but you could go to iPadOS or go back. And on iOS, just scroll down and get to where it says enroll your device. Now, it's going to talk a little bit about how to back up your device that I just walked you through if you scroll through some of the instructions here. Now, go ahead and tap on enroll your device or your iOS device. And again, it's telling you to make sure you have a backup. And now we want to install the profile. This is what lets Apple know that we want the beta on this device. So tap on download profile. We'll wait for it here just a moment. And it says this website is trying to download a configuration profile. Do you want to allow this? Go ahead and tap on allow. And it says profile downloaded. Tap on close. Now we're going to go back into settings. So within settings, you'll see it says profile downloaded at the top. Tap on this, and now we can install the beta profile. You'll see it here. It says iOS 15 and iPadOS 15 beta software profile. Tap on install, put in your passcode for your phone, and then you'll tap on install again, and then again on the bottom. And now it will ask you to restart your device. Go ahead and tap on restart, and this will install the beta profile. Now, when the phone starts back up, you'll want to go to settings. Under settings, go to general, then tap on software update. It will take a moment. Make sure you're on Wi-Fi, as this is a pretty large download, although you may be able to download it on cellular depending on where you live. We'll just wait for a moment for it to check, and then we'll be able to install this. Now, if you're not seeing this, make sure you have on download only for automatic updates. If you have automatic updates turned on, it won't necessarily find it. And you can see it says iOS 15 public beta 2. Now, this is really the first version of the public beta, but they're naming it public beta 2 in order to match developer beta 2, which is the exact same thing. So you can learn more about it. It doesn't really do anything here yet, but go ahead and download and install. Again, it's a very large update. And once it's installed, you'll have iOS 15. So go ahead and do that now. Now, once your iPhone installed iOS 15 and then reboots, you should have iOS 15 on the latest version after you installed the public beta. Now, keep in mind, it is a beta and can have some issues. And if you ever want to revert back to iOS 14, you'll actually have to use a computer to do that. So you'll need a Mac using the Finder or a Windows computer using iTunes. So if you're a little bit apprehensive about upgrading to iOS 15 betas, I would wait until the final release, which is generally around September at some point. However, if you know the risk involved and you have some issues with it, then go ahead and install it. And if you are having problems, make sure that you're reporting those in the Feedback app. The Feedback app is important not only for reporting bugs, but gives you the latest information of notes as well. So if you go into Feedback, you can see any feedback you provided, and then also, if you go into the inbox, it will give you the latest notes on the latest version you're running. So you can see here, if we go down to iOS and iPadOS 15 Beta 2 release notes, it will give you information about what they changed with known issues, what might not work properly, and things such as maybe a known issue here that says you can call and build against the new AV control API. So if you're a developer, that's for you. Or live text may be unavailable in the camera. That's a known issue, and there could be issues with panorama mode. So this is important to know what's going on throughout the OS. If there's problems and you're experiencing them, make sure it's not in here first before reporting the feedback, as they may already be aware of it. And it's labeled based on alphabetical, based on what the actual issue could be. So FaceTime, for example, or files, or Find My. So just keep that in mind. So this is a good place to go and find that information. And then if you do have a problem, go ahead and report a bug. Tap on the button in the bottom right, fill out the form, and then you can report whatever bug you're having, and then they'll prioritize it and work on it from there. So it's important to do that as a beta tester. So if you're having major issues, they can figure out what's going on and pull diagnostics directly from your phone to do that. And so hopefully that helped you install iOS 15 public beta. Let me know how it's going for you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.